That is just to also hint that is not only to promote patriotism but also to promote punctuality. That is one buy. He gave the teacher 100 rupees. I may not be coming this month. I'm having lot of work, badminton, exercise, and tennis course. I'm going. I may not come properly. So you keep it for over 45 months, 45 days. That is 1 month. So this is not a proper way. If something is given as an exemption, making the exemption as a regulatory exercise, it is too much dishonest. Likewise, whenever we are in apathy, emergency or unavoidability, we have to see that we can maintain the time or not. That is entirely different. But taking that into consideration, taking every hour of our life to be exceptional, considering our opportunities to be exemptive in nature, considering our status to be so exceptional, we must not misbehave. So there is a kala. At that kala, that period, we have to consume something. See, I want to tell you something. Anybody, akala grahana, kala agrahana. Whenever there is a period for food, if you are not taking anything, your ayush is reduced. Whenever ayukta kala, whenever there is not the time you are taking something, your sampati is reduced. Your productivity, your wealth is reduced. So that's why Shastra say, if there is a proper timing for food, you can design any timing as per your school or other things. That is nonsensical. You have to, see, first you have to live. First you have to be productive. That is done by Anna only. Afterwards only you are a professional person, you are an athletic person, media icon, a political idol, or a universal demon, whatever it may be. Everything is based on your body, your life, your health, and your productivity. If you are sacrificing everything, just what you are going to earn and for whom? That is the thing. And if you follow everything, that will have some sort of genetic erosion, and your children will be the xerox copy of the same thing, same mistakes. And they will do more things. So it will give a very great drastic genetic erosion or aberration by which the basic principles of maintaining food, water, and air, that itself is lost. Now, human being can operate aircrafts. He can operate lot of machineries and computational devices. He can operate lot of other rockets and other things, satellites. But he don't know how to operate three things. One is food, second is water, third is air. He don't know how to respire. He don't know how to maintain pollution-free water and how to drink that, how to make water resourceful. He don't know how to eat and he is not eating at all. He is following this bovenial animals and he is following cobra and other things. Cobra that will swallow. And cobra is not having the digestive juice, supportive juice, just as we are having. We are having three supportive juices. One is the canal juice, and say first is the sublingual juice, third is the intestinal juice. We are having three juices, but cobra is having only one juice, very powerful juice. So it used to swallow and then take rest for months together, everything is swallowed inside. We are also taking like that, like cobra, we are swallowing, but we don't have that constitution at all. And bovenial animals, you know that they swallow, then they bring it back to their mouth, then crush it with their jaws and teeth, then sublingual absorption and dilution is made. That provision is not there with us. Can we do like that? But a lot of people are doing like that only. That is that. So we know how we have to take this food. So the time has come for the science or for the awareness, social awareness or scientific awareness or spiritual awareness. These three awareness campaigns should be made for teaching the human being how to deal with food, air and water. After spoiling everything, who is going to play with the machines? You will be dead, or totally imbecile, or crippled, or paralyzed. Who is going to play the machines and rackets? So after a few generations, if you are not going to be aware, or vigilant, or meticulously observant in your methodologies, only the world will be filled with machines and craps, and nobody will be there to operate. So these three things are very basic essentialities. Let everybody invent everything, but we have a very strong intellectual base. Or knowledge service for these sciences. So it is known as Anna Vidhi. First is Kala. That's why I want to say, whenever, there is one more thing in Ayurveda. Whenever you want water, that is a different instinct. Whenever you want solid energy through blood, that is a different instinct. But whenever you are hungry, you are drinking water. Whenever you are thirsty, you are eating something. That is also not good. So we have to say, whenever there is a Yukta Kala, Shastrokta Kala, at that time, at least a handful of something. Either it may be a fruit or a vegetable or anything else. Even diabetic people, at that time, if they take a small quantity, it is not going to disturb at all. It is an unwanted fear. Howsoever, maybe the people may be sick or anything, at the regular time, if you take, apart from the time, you see, there are two things. One, for substantially giving the fuel for your operations, that particular time is used. After that only, it is disintegrated into different parts and glucose, its absorption, everything is made later. That is entirely different. I want to say, if you are taking yukta kale, yadya grihitam, sarvam tat sukhatam bhavet. If you are taking a small quantity at an appropriate time, you need not bother about your sickness or your unadaptability or thing. But it must be the appropriate time and it should be limited. So I want to say to everybody, at that appropriate time, take something. Don't be empty. At a later time, whenever you have your timings, meeting or something else, eating and meeting has lot of clashes. Everybody is postponing their eatings because of meetings, considering that as more significant. But still, they can have a handful of something. They can have pishta, what we call pishta in Sanskrit. They can have the flour of good cereals, germinated sprout cereals. They can carry and do that. Otherwise, they can take a cup of milk or they can take one or two bananas. It's very simple. One apple, it is not going to harm at all. That particular time, it should be honored. The inner mechanism or the instinctive call should be honored. It is known as kala. Second is dik. We don't know about dik, which is east, west, we don't know. But Shastra says that we have to see some direction and do that. South is preferred in Shastras for food. Because that is that induces more energy. And a common upachara, common courtesy is east and north. But for food, south is preferable. We will discuss these things later. That is dik nirnaya. Dravya nirnaya, Swami has told us to eat, so we can eat anything. That is a dravya which we can take. So anything is having innumerable differentiations. Swabhava tushta. We used to say, what is swabhava tushta? That which is naturally prohibited. Ashraya dushta is that which is not naturally prohibited but circumstantially prohibited. For example, if something has an insect, something has hair inside, something is brought, the Shastras, for there are three types of people. Those who eat for survival. Second type of people, those who are doing advanced things. Third type of people, those who are doing a tapasya, a lifetime mission in spiritual field. For the third type of people, they are having a lot of restrictions, which need not be these people, for these people. If you are not having any scooter, what is the necessity for your helmet? It is not essential at all. There are some exercises which are going to safeguard your tapasya, the penance. If you have no tapasya, then why you are going to safeguard, what you are going to safeguard? So, drashta, a person who sees. Pariveshakaha, one who serves. Sahabhokta, a person who is sitting and eating with us. Panti, the row and the people sitting in the row. Drashta, the person who is seeing at the time of cooking. And Pachaka, the person who is cooking for that. Aneta, the person from whom the ingredients are brought or bought. Kalpaka, the person who is cultivating. All of these people's sins and virtues are there embedded inside the food. But they are so subtle, if you are seeing a lot of things, you cannot eat throughout your life. So, maybe the Shastras say that two things are said in Shastras. Number one, it is meant for people, those who are in spiritual mission or mission of realizing inner energy, number one. And number two, they say that these things can be easily propitiated or mitigated by means of mantra. So whatever that is there or there not, whatever there is, the positivity or negativity, whatever it may be, positive induction and negativity reduction, there is a common exercise or prayer which can be done regularly by all people without considering or evaluating or exactly estimating who has done this. So we need not go for this scrutiny, exploration, CBI investigation, etc. We are having the food, whatever it may be, either visible or invisible, let all the sins, let all the evil installations inside, let them disappear. Let the food be a proper suitable tool for me. Let me be a suitable and eligible agent for getting